Scentsy event. Wow. That's amazing. That is amazing. You'll never miss another family reunion. I promise you that. This is my, I think, sixth one. And I won't miss one if I can help it. So, I want to welcome everybody, and I want to let you know a little bit about myself. My name is Shana Giles. If y'all can't hear me, let me know, because I can pull this thing out and talk. So, my name is Shana Giles, and I am from Crestview, Florida. I'm a store director in Florida, and I have been with Scentsy. It will be 7 years in September. And I do not plan on giving up on it. I've kind of preached to my team about sticking with it, persistence, that's the key to everything. So, let's see. Just so you know, I've been shaking all day. I'm a nervous wreck, and I will probably jump around. Okay, so, let's see. Let's get started on some fundraisers. How many of you have done fundraisers before? That is a good number. That's a really good number. So the rest of you are ready to learn from those of you that have done them. So we'll just bring everybody up here that's done them, and y'all can come. Okay. Let's see. I can pass this slide. Okay. So this, everyone, is my why. This is why I do what I do. You'll see the picture up top is me and my three babies, and that's my three babies right there. And of course, that's some of my team over there. My team and my friends I've met in Scentsy and anyone I meet, they're my family, along with my personal family, of course. But they're all my family, and they are part of why I do what I do. I'm going to give you a little background about myself, and I hope I don't cry. But I want you to know where I'm coming from and that this is from my heart. I do everything I do because of all of them. So, let me find my place. I joined Scentsy as a hobby. My husband was a career military officer. And I joined as a hobby. And I decided that when I found it, there was not a consultant in the area that I wanted to do a party at. So I decided, well, I'll join and I'll start doing parties. So it still was a hobby for me until, until my why quickly changed. My why originally was to go and have fun and that was it. But my why changed in a matter of a year after starting Scentsy. I got pregnant with my baby girl right there. That's Addie. And tomorrow is her birthday. She'll be six. And it was a few months after I started Scentsy. Realized my husband, which is an RN, I realized that he had a prescription pain medication addiction. And he was slowly spiraling out of control. I didn't know anything about it for a long time until it started spiraling out of control. He lost his 13-year military career, which lost our income. Ended up in rehab. We had no income. And I had to do something. I didn't want to be in that position ever again. I had to do something. So I turned to Scentsy. That's when I decided that Scentsy is what was going to keep us afloat. And Scentsy was what was going to keep me from being in that position ever again. So I'm still able to stay at home with my kids. I struggle all the time, but I still own my home, which we almost lost. After almost an 18-year marriage, I'm now a recent single mom, which is really tough. But I have complete faith that I am where I'm supposed to be. So I love being involved in my kids. And that's kind of where my love for fundraisers came from. As you know, schools struggle with money a lot of times. And I do more fundraisers than just schools, but I get excited about fundraisers. I love when I have parents come up to me and say, this is something different. I love it. I'm so excited. Or I was looking for a consultant in my area. I just moved here and I saw the fundraiser come home. Or I'd rather spend money on this than a box of candy that's $20. So that's kind of where I started doing this. Scentsy's about changing lives. It's changed mine. It's really changed mine. And it's changed others I know. And you have the opportunity to change lives with fundraisers and giving back. So, let's see. And that's kind of my slide on that. I should have flipped it. I'm sorry, y'all. I got caught up in a crime. Okay, so we're going to start with some of the benefits of fundraisers. So this all leads me to the benefits. I know some of you look at fundraisers and say, but I have to give my commission away. I don't want to give my commission away. That's how I make money. Believe me, that's how I support my family. We don't want to give our commission away. But you can also give back to your community and still, in the long run, benefit from fundraisers. So, stop. When you do fundraisers, and I don't want to trip on my cord. When you do fundraisers, if you look at that right there, and that right there, and those boxes right there, those are fundraisers that I did for my kids' school. And the stock that you can get from the free and half price, you can help to recoup some of your funds. That's going to give you...
Can't hear me?
Okay.
Without the microphone.
I'll tell you what. I'm going to take this off. See if that works.
Take it off.
Not that. Y'all don't want to see that. Maybe Mama Bat, no. Okay, so the free and half price you can get with the fundraisers. It's phenomenal. You have a huge fundraiser, you can get tons of free product. That free product, you'll have it on hand for your customers. You'll have it to sell at events if you need to sell it at events. But you're going to recoup some of your funds with the free and half price. Next thing, recruits. And I have a perfect example in the room right now of a recruit. You can recruit through fundraisers. I place the $99 sticker on every single fundraiser brochure that goes home with these kids. So that way all the parents know that they can start their own business for $99. So you can recruit. And I have Stephanie here. She's been with Scentsy 2 months. 2 months. You have how many in your downline? Four in her downline already. And she's here today. And I met her 2 years ago through a school fundraiser. It took her 2 years to decide to join. She went back and forth for 2 years. But you see where she is, and she's phenomenal. So that is the perfect example of recruiting. You can put parties. When I said something a few minutes ago about someone not finding or not knowing a consultant in their area, I had someone call me. She had just moved there to where I live, and she didn't have a consultant. She was so excited when she saw the fundraiser come home because she needed Scentsy. And believe me, this girl needs Scentsy bad because she goes nuts over it. She buys anything and everything. So she's got parties booked for me. She's brought in new customers for me. So that's another benefit of fundraisers. Let's go on. Of course, new customers, like I kind of just covered a little bit. You've got your new customers. Sometimes you have those that have lost their consultant, or their consultants quit, or their consultants moved. So you've always got someone like that. Let's see, brand awareness. You're getting the Scentsy brand and your name out there to these people. There are still people out there, believe me, lots of people that have never heard of Scentsy. I run across them every day, and I know you do too. So it's brand awareness. Getting that name out there, letting them know who you are and who Scentsy is and what we do. So, incentive trip points, my favorite. How many of you have been on a Scentsy incentive trip? So you know how spoiled rotten you become on a Scentsy incentive trip, right? Those incentive trip points, fundraisers are great to earn incentive trip points. So always remember that. Your PRV from fundraisers, possible recruiting, parties, all of that. Set some goals now. If you have not earned an incentive trip, I challenge you to set some goals. Sit down when the incentive trip is announced. Break it down monthly and set your goals monthly to earn that incentive trip. Think about fundraisers. Fundraisers can help you do that. Let's see. PRB we've kind of covered. Annual sales award. Anyone in here earn the annual sales award? Yay! Congratulations. That's awesome. So if you don't know about the annual sales award, that is another benefit to fundraisers. You have the opportunity to earn this each year by having 30,000 in PRB points within, and I always forget the months because I changed them. I never do know.
May 1st
to April 31st. You have the chance to earn incentive trip points. For annual sales award. And then, of course, giving back. Scentsy is a very generous company, as we all know. I want to strive in my life to be as generous. Fundraisers are an excellent way to give back. That is an excellent way to show everyone how generous Scentsy is and how generous we are as Scentsy consultants. Okay, so I kind of added this to my presentation this morning, that not the organization's part, but a little bit about it. So I know a lot of you want to know, how do I get fundraisers? I've had that question asked so many times. What you want to do, how do I approach sale the Scentsy fundraiser instead of fundraising companies that offer 50%? Have y'all ran into that where the fundraising companies offer 50%?
Yes.
And you're competing with that? This is what you want to do. You need to be confident in yourself and confident in our product. You need to sell yourself, and don't laugh, your services. I know that sounds awful, but that's kind of what you're selling. You're selling yourself, and you're selling the product. So let them know what all you're going to do for them as opposed to those companies. Because when those companies come in, everyone has to volunteer to help out. When they do a Scentsy fundraiser, you do all the work. You give back. You're the one. So the PTO. PTO is not trying to find volunteers. You're going to be the one doing that. And they, believe me, schools love it. And other organizations love it. Because they don't have to find the volunteers. I've had our school come back to me 3 times without me even asking again. Because they knew they didn't have to get volunteers. They said, that's the easiest way we've ever been able to make money. Because I direct all of the questions to me that parents have, any of the problems, front office has my information. Everything comes to me. They don't have to get volunteers. They don't have to do it themselves. I do all the delivering. They are so excited because those parents get so stressed out trying to do everything on their own. So when you sell your services and yourself, that is a great incentive for them to go with the Scentsy fundraiser. I package all the orders. I deliver them. All the parent questions come to me. Let's see. I have lost my place. So if you're not comfortable with large fundraisers, you can always start with small organizations. And we're going to cover a few types of fundraisers that are great to do with small organizations. If I can ever get through all this. Once the community starts seeing how easy it is to work with you as a Scentsy consultant and to work with you on fundraisers, your name's going to get out there. You're going to want to also advertise fundraisers on social media. I got my fundraiser that starts in September just by saying something on social media. And it's actually a football coach that I went to high school with. And he contacted me and he said, my boys are doing this fundraiser. I want them to. He was so excited about it. He's more excited than the women. So don't just think you are targeting women for fundraisers. So here's some of the organizations. These are great organizations. Schools, dance groups. I've got one starting with a dance group. Cheer groups. Bands. Mission trips. I've done a few mission trip fundraisers. Those are great because you're working with a very small group of people and you're supporting an amazing cause. Pet rescue societies, youth groups, school clubs, school trips, individuals, and I know that might sound bad, but I have had people on my team do fundraisers for people that have lost their home, people that are sick, people that have cancer, people that have to travel because of medical reasons. Those are good fundraiser options. And they appreciate it, and they're so loving to you that you're giving back to them. So we've got the traditional fundraiser, which is kind of what I do with the schools. And I know this is an old picture, but it's kind of the only one I could find at the time. But we use the fundraiser flyers or the showcase brochures. That's what I use. I use the Scentsy fundraising envelopes. And that's a picture of my packets ready to go to a school. And that's just one box of them. There were several boxes of them because it was like 800 and something kids. But that's how I package them into the classrooms, put it in the teacher's boxes. I do all of that. They do not do that. Okay, what to include in your packet? This is what I like to include. Now, everybody this is your own business. This is your individual thoughts. This is what I like to include in mine. Showcase brochure. I label everything. I have my name all over everything. I label the brochure. I put a rub and smell. This is actually a picture of one of mine that I scanned in. My kids do my stickers, so they're not always straight, but I let my kids do my stickers. I even pay some of the neighborhood kids sometimes to come do them, and they love it. And we just kind of all sit in the living room and put stickers on things, so they think it's cool. But the rub and smell sticker, the $99 sticker that I was telling you, I put an order form in there. There's a parent info sheet, fundraiser envelope, teacher letter on top of that, letting the teachers know, because sometimes I will do a teacher giveaway and they will promote it within their classroom. So a teacher letter, and that actually worked this last time. It's not worked before, but it worked this last time. I had a teacher, name's Miss Joseph, and she promised her kids a pizza party if they would win her a Scentsy warmer. The kids got so excited, and I could tell, I asked her, I said, did you promote this? Because your class did really, really well. She said, and then one of the kids shouted out, yeah, she told us she'd give us a pizza party if we won her a Scentsy warmer. So she won herself a Scentsy warmer in a cent, and she was so excited. I put flyers. I hang flyers up all over the school, or all over if it's a dance studio, or make sure the parents know and the kids know what's going on. I put a little bitty, all my PTO ones that go home, or my school ones that go home, I put a little quick info sheet on there, because parents, they don't always read everything. They don't read all the information inside. I'm bad about that. I don't always read everything. So I'll put that, and I'll show you a picture of that in a second. This is my parent info sheet. I know it's hard to read, but I have everything laminated over here. At the end of the session, if you want to look at it front and back, so you can kind of take a look at things. And I know things are going to change now with the new logo, the new products, all of that, but it kind of gives you an idea of what I have in there. This is, not everyone needs a tax cheat sheet. In Okaloosa County, where I live, our kids, we have to charge tax on our school fundraisers. So I have a tax cheat sheet that I made up, so it's quick. For the parents, they don't have to figure tax. Order form, and I really don't know. I should show that order form. That is a very old Scentsy fundraiser order form. I'm really not sure if I should have put that on there. 7 years old. It was like when I first started. But that's the order form I like, and I wish they'd bring them back.
I wish they would too. Yeah.
We need to talk to them. We've tried. Not right now, no.
So you could just
that's
it or put it
this is what they used to have, and I loved them.
But now they're just all plain.
Now they're just all the plain order forms. So, but
do
that's.
Do you make copies or do you send all originals?
I don't have all originals. I make copies, but I make sure I make it front and back because the back has all of the disclaimer information on it. So if you do copies, make front and back. I don't know if that's. It's illegal, but
well, it's such an expense.
It's a very big expense. And when you're dealing with 800 something kids, it's even more. So, and that's a teacher letter. And like I said, everything's over there on that table. And feel free to take a look at it. But I know I'll have to change up my form soon. Yes, ma'am.
Did you create the teacher's letter yourself? Or is that something that Scentsy generated?
No, that's something that, I don't even remember where I got it. I've had it so long. I don't think I created that one. I can't remember if I borrowed that one from another consultant or she, you know, she let me, and I just kind of tweaked it for myself. Or if that's when I, no, I actually created that one, I think. The parent letter, I did not. I know who that came from, and I just tweaked it for myself.
Hey, Shana, I saw in there you said make checks too. Do you know?
Yes.
How do you work that?
With the checks?
Yeah.
If it's the school, I work it out with the bookkeeper. They make checks to the school, and then we have to make sure everything matches, and I have to create an invoice for the school, and then they write me one check. Okay. And I actually take that check to their bank, cash it, put the cash in my account, so I don't have to wait.
And that way they deal with any bounce
checks. They deal with any bounce checks. Mm-hmm. Now, if it's smaller organizations, I did one for a group of clogging girls. Mm-hmm. They all made checks out to me, but their fundraiser was actually bigger than some big groups because it was an individual. Those girls were working towards making money for themselves to pay their dance. So, but yeah, it just depends. But with the school, definitely work it out with them. To have them do it. Yes, ma'am.
Is there a chance that any of these will be on in the resources or training center?
Or even a Facebook group?
I can upload them to a group. I can upload them to a group.
Well, I can't read the pictures once I take them. So.
Yeah.
Which group?
I'm not doing it on time.
Yeah, we need to go to the group.
Which group?
How much more?
20 minutes.
Okay, I got a break. I have more information. Yes, ma'am.
You said you delivered those personally to the people?
I do.
From the orders or how?
No, I deliver, when it comes to a school, I deliver it to the, I put it by customer and then by student. So then I'll deliver it to the student of the school. So they'll take it home just like they take home a regular fundraiser. So, yes, ma'am. I do not have a contract with them. Now, I did have, I take that back. I have one right now with the football team. I have to sign some paperwork, and there's some sort of contract thing in there that I haven't looked over yet, but it's the first time I've ever had to do it. But I have
it's
to do
their
it.
Contract, not
yes.
Your contract.
No, it's not mine. It's theirs. But I do have to sign something for them, and that's the first time I've had to do that. So, yes, ma'am.
Do you do combine and saves?
I do, and that's one thing I was going to cover, how you can, I do combine and saves for everything. So if someone orders three bars.
For the customers?
Oh, for the customers?
Or is a bar $5?
Not on a fundraiser. Only if they are current customers and they call me and say, hey, can I do this? I know y'all offer this combine and save. Because what you're dealing with fundraisers is you want the kids or the organization to make as much money as they can. And the only way they can do that is they don't offer the combine and saves and the showcase brochures. Not to mention, it's a whole lot more simple for them to look through. So, no, I use showcase brochures and do not offer combined saves on that. So, okay, let me move on. That is an example of kind of what I hung up around the school with the prizes for the kids, so the kids knew what the prizes were. And then that's kind of that's four of them. But that's the quick sheet that I put on the front of the brochure. Are you going to go back? Okay, sorry. Ready? All right. Now, these are the non-traditional or innovative fundraisers that Scentsy's going to be talking a lot about that we need to cover, such as I know a lot of you have questions about Scent Circle fundraisers. Is that, that was a misspelled word. Okay, Scent Circle fundraiser. You can do a Scentsy Bar fundraiser, a Nightlight and Bar fundraiser, Element Warmer and Bar, Deluxe or Premium Warmer and Bar. You can create whatever you want to make a simple fundraiser. Combine anything that you want. Let me get over here. Sorry.
So the group that you'll be setting this up on, will you have all of these different pictures available on there too?
Oh, I can, yeah. That's not a problem.
You want to set it up? I'll set it up. Show me what to name it. Yeah.
I think you sold
S H A N A. That way I could, I don't know, I could talk to
Scentsy.
S H A N A. They're going to have some S H A N A. Scentsy is going to have some new fundraising documents coming out.
All right, let's do.
So, I haven't seen them yet, but I know that they said they're going to have some new ones coming out. So, these are just some great ideas for fundraisers. Patty Knight came up with some of the Scent Circle fundraiser forms you're going to see. And then I have a downline, Mike DeGallier. He came up with some of the fundraiser forms you're going to see. So I did not create any of these forms because I am not good with all that. But they were excellent and let me, they were really sweet, let me use their forms. So Scent Circle fundraisers. This is an example of the proposal letter that you can use, and there's some of those over there, to try to grab your Scent Circle fundraisers. Those are good for small organizations, for first starting out with fundraisers. That's the one that I'll be doing with the dance studio. They are perfect. They're so easy. They're easier than any fundraiser you'll ever do. This is an example of the letter that went out to the dance studio to the parents. That's what's going to go out. So it's $20 for a six-pack of Scent Circles. It's a flat $20. That's going to include your any shipping tax, anything. That's what you're going to charge for the Scent Circle fundraisers, a six-pack. And this will show you. It's just like kind of like a Girl Scout cookie form. You've got your scents, and then you've got the place for their name. You want to try to collect all their contact information because that's where you're going to get new customers. These people, once they get their Scent Circles, they're going to want more. Obviously, six Scent Circles aren't going to last forever. So you want to create, you want to try to get all of their contact information. It's super simple for the kids because all they have to collect is $20. There's no tax, there's no shipping, there's no adding this, adding that. The parent or the customer will go through and they will mark how many of each scent they want. You do not have to offer every scent. I would offer the favorites and that's it. I would not offer every scent. So they'll go through and do that and give them $20. And the organization, you can choose what you want them, what you want to give back to them. I've heard some give $5 back, heard some give $6 back per six pack. You can give up to $7 back per six pack. So I will probably, with the dance studio, because it's for my daughter, I will probably be giving $7 back. But you choose how you need to do it, because it's your business and you know what you can afford to give back. And it's the same with regular fundraisers. You don't have to give 30% back or 25% back. I mean, I would give as much back as you can, but you choose that. You know what you can afford to do.
What's that smell on you?
Which one?
That really smells.
Oh, sorry, I forgot to cover that. Yes, my downline Mike made that, which is amazing. I love this rub and smell sheet. What he does is he
so
takes these scents.
So it should say rub and not run.
Oh, oh yeah, it should. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yep, run and smell.
Run and smell. Same thing.
So, okay, he created this, and what you do is you just get the rub and smell stickers, so they'll know what scents they're getting. They'll know what they smell like. Stick them on each one, and that can go in the packet with the Scent Circle fundraisers. Because people are going to ask, well, I don't know what this smells like. I don't know what that smells like. Because there's no description here. It's just the name of the scent. So if you put the rub and smells in there, they're more apt to buy. Yes, ma'am. I do not. And the only reason I don't is because as a director, we make 9% back on our wholesale, and I use that amount to cover supplies. But not everybody can do that, so yes, I do know consultants that do, I just don't. I give them the full amount back, the 25 to 30%, whatever they've earned. But like I said, all of that is up to you as an individual because you know what you can afford. Okay, here's a breakdown and ways to use Scent Circles. You could always put this in there. It's going to tell people different ways because not everybody's going to think, they're going to think, oh, I could just use it in my car. Well, you can use Scent Circles many ways. You can put them in trash cans, lockers, They're great stocking stuffers, small bathrooms, in your office, closets, return air vents, cars. Anybody else have any ideas?
Yeah.
Under the sink.
Birthday card. There's just so many options. So if you put all of those on there, people are going to start thinking outside of the box, and more people are going to buy, and more people, there are more they're going to buy. All right, that's just an example of, is that the scent? That's the scent bar one, I think. Okay, so that's the scent bar one. And that you just, that's the same concept, it's just scent bars. So it's the exact same concept as the scent circles. You do the exact same thing, but it's, you just do it with bars. And there's some of the other options. Like I said, you could do the nightlight and bar, element warmer, deluxe warmer, premium warmer, that and the bar. And those are great ways to get new customers because you're giving them a little taste of Scentsy without overloading them with the full catalog. You're getting them started. Yes, ma'am.
Do you give them one bar for each thing, or how does that go?
For the scent bar one?
Yeah. For the warmer in the bar.
Oh, warmer in the bar? I know that Mike was developing it where he wanted to do a warmer in three bars. I would personally do, I want to do a warmer in one bar. That's just me. I want to make it more like that, more affordable.
What price point would you put that at in order to make it a fundraiser?
The nightlight and bar?
Yeah.
$25.
So you would do it as a 25 instead of doing it?
Because you're going to be able to put them into combine and saves. And it's going to work out like that. So, yes.
Would you do a nightlight, like they order their nightlight and then they pick a bar? They can do, like, buy as many bars as they want and get nightlights as they want? Or should you do just like one bar and one nightlight?
Well, that's your repeat business, though. That's your repeat business. If they
right.
If you're selling one bar, then they come back.
They come back. You want to get, you just want to try to get them, get the brand out there and. You want them to buy, because some of these people have never tried Scentsy, and this gives them an opportunity to say, okay, well, I'm going to get just this nightlight and this one bar, and I'm going to try it, because I'm helping an organization. Whereas if they went to a party or they were just talking to you, they may not buy, but they're helping an organization. They may be helping a little child. They may be helping a family. So I would say one nightlight and one bar, and then you can have, and then they're hooked, obviously. Everybody knows Scentsy customers get hooked. You try it one time, you're hooked.
So are you just using, because I'm in love with that idea, you're just using those nine particular...
I would choose whatever you want.
Or can you use, like, make your own flyer up and use the whole catalog, whatever's in the catalog.
Right.
And then whatever scent, you know...
You want to make it as simple as you can. For something like this, you want to make it simple. I would pick fundraiser. I would pick some. You can use all of them if you want. I mean, there's not a whole lot of nightlights, so. And then just pick favorites on scents.
Or so pick like 10 warmers to pick from.
Right.
10 bars to pick from.
Exactly. Make it simple. Okay. Key points, because I'm running out of time. We covered traditional fundraisers, what to include in them, some innovative or non-traditional fundraisers. You want to gather all of your customer info that you can because that's how you're going to contact them. That's how you're going to get back in touch with them. You need to file that information away and you need to refer back to that. A few months after the fundraiser, send them an email. Call them. Send them a postcard. Do something to get those return customers because those people may not know how to contact you. They may not know a lot about Scentsy. So you want to gather all the information you can from those customers so you can contact them in a couple of months because I promise you, you contact them, you might have, you're going to have no's. You're going to have people that say, oh, no, I'm not going to order. But you're going to have people say, I'm so glad you called me because I had no idea how to get in touch with you. So what I like to do when I send home the orders, I like to include a sample with a thank you and I do it on the back of the print your own business cards from Scentsy. I will type it in. The sample goes on the front, and then I thank them for supporting the organization. I put on there the amount that they helped raise for that organization, what the scent is, and my contact information. I know that's a lot because it's very small in there. Okay. But that's how I do it. Great way to get customer contacts, PRV, incentive trip points, free and half price, give back to your community, and of course, as Scentsy says, give more than you take. So, let's see where we are. We're about done. All right, actually, we only have 5 minutes left. So, I want to get somebody to answer this, a couple of people. What additional products or distribution methods could you use with the new catalog?
Car wires.
Car wires. Very good.
Those little mini bags. Clip-ons. Okay. So, you want to come get something?
Yes.
Did you answer the first one? Y'all can use these to annoy everybody. Buddy clips. Who said buddy clips?
I don't care.
Everybody did.
Hey, Shana, you want to give this a Facebook real quick?
Who else?
Just toss them.
I'm just going to set these here. Because I don't want to. I'm afraid I'm going to hit somebody if I throw that out. Y'all want to throw it out?
Go.
Okay, so that's great. Now, I want somebody to come up with a different organization than what I listed. Somebody go with another one.
Cheerleaders.
I said cheerleaders.
Girls help.
Nursing group. Nursing unit. Church group. I said
group. Very
good. Okay, so what did we learn? Take care of someone else. Be there for someone else. Bless someone else. A happy life is about giving more than you take. And that is an example of, I love this quote from Martin Luther King. Life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others? And that's something where we were, some of us Scentsy consultants were giving back during the Tuscaloosa tornado in 2011. We were out. We collected a bunch of stuff, and we were out delivering things. All right. So you make a living by what you earn, and you make a life by what you give. That is an excellent quote by Sir Winston Churchill. And if y'all have any questions, feel free to come see me. And I'm sorry I had to cut it off so quick at the end, but...